Hello friend, this is Swapnil and welcome to Learn SAP ABAP. So in this session we are going to see how to create search help, that is elementary search help and collective search help in SAP ABAP, and how to use it in a model per program. Okay, so what is a elementary search help? So elementary search help is for F4 help, and it is define a search path where we will define the table from which the data has to be read and the selection criteria. Okay, and yeah, so it is used when we get the data from the single table. And what about the collective search help? So collective search help is the collection of the elementary search help. So basically we include the elementary search help in the collective search help. So when we need to fetch the data based on the multiple selection criteria, so then we will use the collective search help. Okay, and so today first we are going to create a two different elementary search help, and then we are going to use this search help in a collective search help, and we will see how it displays the value in a search help. Okay, so let's get started. But wait, if you are the first time on my channel, then please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get notification of my upcoming videos. Okay, so stay tuned in the end and keep watching Learn SAP ABAP. So now we are going to create the elementary search help. So before that, we just need to create a two table. Okay, because we are going to create a two elementary search help, and we are going to add this elementary search help in a collective search help. Okay, so let's see how we can. For two different elementary search help, we need a two different table. But we are going to take first our table, which is a employee data. As you already know, we are always using this table for our video. So this is our first table. Okay, and we are going to create a second table also. So we'll create this second table, student EMP. Okay, it's a student data. Let's click on create. Student details, allow, then click on the entry. We'll use mandate free and student roll number, and yes, name, so student name. Okay, we'll give the key field for the roll number and mandate. Okay, and use a built-in type. Okay, you always try to use the data element. Okay, because this is our testing table, so that is the reason I'm not going to create any data element, but always just you always keep in this practice to create a data element. Okay, so we'll give the mandate. Okay, so we'll click on a built-in. Now here we will touch num2, and here we have the roll number 2, and sname we give as a cal 10. Okay, here we give the student name. Okay, check, and an object will create enhancement category. Click on enhancement category. It can be enough, and also then we need to define a technical setting. Yes, 01. Okay, check activate. Now we'll check and activate. Okay, so this is our first table, the student employee, and let's see 11 ZMP data. Okay, this is our second table. Okay, so what we are going to use is we are going to create the search help for this name. Okay, and here also we have a name. We'll insert some data inside this. Just leave it. Table entries, create roll number 01. Use the hash, save. Then again we'll create another entry. Utilities contain create entries 02 will give as a Jackson. Then we'll create one more entries table create, and 03 then will give as a Mayur. Okay, save. Now we will see our entry. Let's execute this. So now you can see our entry. So this is the Mahesh Jackson Mayur, and in our second table, let me open the second table also. So here also we have a entry in this table. Okay, which is a
this is the one. Mahesh Ramesh is opening Mahesh. Okay, those are the entry. Okay, entries. Okay, so now we will create our second cell check. Okay, so let's go back. Okay, so this is our table, Joomla table. We'll create another session, C11. So here in the search help, just click on search help. We first of all we will create the elementary search help. So for that, Z test battery emp search. Okay, use the name of the emp search, create. So now here we have to select the elementary search. Okay, so now here give you the employee search help. Okay, and in the method you have to enter the our employee table name. Okay, gmp underscore data. Okay, this is our employee table data name. Okay, and here you just need to pass the field name. Let's go to our table. This is our table, employee data, and here employee data we will pass this first name. Okay, so here we will pass first name, importing, exporting, position is position one. Okay, click on enter. Caro 10. Okay, just check. And so now we have defined our first elementary search help. Now we will define the second elementary search help, which is the student one. Okay, first we will show execute this. I will show you the output. So as you can see here, first name, if I will click on the F4, it's giving me all the values from the table. Okay, let's create the another one here, search help. Go back, we'll give the Z test st stud search. Okay, and here again do the same elementary search help. Okay, and here we'll give the name as a student search help, and method here we have to give the name of the second table. Okay, which is a Z student data, right? Let me correct, let me check. Z student employee, sorry, Z student employee. Okay, and here we have to give the name as a from this table. Okay, so from this table what the field we have is a S name, I think so. Okay, so we'll give here S name, enter, import export 11. Char 10. Okay, we have created both the elementary search. Let's execute this. So here also you can see our Jackson, Mahesh and Mayur. Okay, this is this value we are getting from the student table. Okay, right, student employee. So now we will go to back and we'll create a collective help. We'll see how we can use this elementary help in collective search. Just click on Z test collective help. Okay, click on the create, select the collective search help. Okay, okay, collective search help, and here we'll give the parameter as a name. Okay, you can import and data element will give the char 10. Okay, now as you can see here included search help, so you have to click in here, and in this search help we have to provide the name of the created search help. Okay, so what, so let's check again what is search help we have created. It was a student search, right? Ztest student search. So we will provide here name, click on the enter, and same for the second one, Ztest. I think it was emp search, right? Enter. Okay, so now once we enter it, just check and activate. No parameter assignment. Okay, so we have to just assign the parameter. Just click on this, select the search help, and click on the assignment. So it will ask for the preferred parameter. Just click on the search help, and as you can see here, it will automatically provide you the name. Okay, so whatever name we have provided. Okay, and click on copy, and do the same thing for the employee also. Click here assignment, and click here and search help, select this name and copy, and we'll execute. Okay, so now we have almost done with our elementary help and collective help. Okay, so we have created two this elementary help. and we have just used this element tree in the collective search help. Okay, so, and we have defined the parameter as the name. Okay, so let's see the output, how it's displaying, how the collective search help will show you the output. Once I click on the execute, so as you can see here the name, right? And name, if I click on the F for help, okay, so in the first thing you can see the student search help, right? The so first thing you in the first time we can see the values from the student search help, right? We have created a student search help, so we are getting this value from this student search help, and next to this student search help you can find the employee search help also, right? If I click on the employee search help, so you can see the values from the employee table. Okay, so and employee table, I will select the Mahesh. You can see the element from student. Now I will select the another value from the employee search help. From here I am just selecting the Swapnil. Okay, so as you can see here Swapnil. Okay, so okay, so this is the way we can create the collective search help. Now we will see how we can use this collective search help in a model pool program. Okay, in model pool program how we can use this search help. Okay, how it will display the data on this screen. Okay, it's very easy. Okay, we'll create one program C38 G test search help. Okay, click on the create test search help program. Here I will say as of now I will select as include executable program. Okay, so inside we will here what we will do, I will just define the parameter, which parameter I want to display the search help. So we will give the employee type DMP data. It will give me all the value, I don't need all the value. We'll give the name for the char 10. Okay, and here we will write a call screen 100 and we need to design the screen. Click on yes. Okay, so here give another screen 1000. Okay, and click on the so you can activate. Click on the layout. So here I will put one box, and here I need a value, right? We'll click on. So we'll click on this dictionary program. I click on the get from the program. So here we have ls employee. Okay, we'll put here, and here we'll use the name as a employee e name, employee name. Okay, double click and fulfill. And here as you can see the search help, right? So here we just need to basically append the name of the collected search help. So go to the one, I will copy our collective search help name. It was gtest call help, copy, and we'll put here. Okay, okay, click on OK, check and activate. Let's share. Okay, so now we will check test the output. Okay, just close this session, check and activate. Okay, so now we will test our program. Okay, so if I will click on the execute. So as you can see employee name, so okay, so if I will click on the so employee for help, so here first in first corner you can see the value from the student search help, and next to the student help you can see the values from the employee search. Okay, so whatever value here, so let's suppose I will select the Jackson, so it will come in the Jackson. We select the another value from another help, so we'll click on the employee search help, and we'll select the some Ritika. So as you can see, so whatever value we are selecting it is selecting. Okay, so using the collective search help we can add the multiple search help to the for help. Okay, so basically the collective search help provide the multiple way of data selection, and each data selection is created by the element searcher and added in a collective search help. Okay, so thank you friends. Okay, so if you want to take the data from the multiple tables, then you can take the help of the collective search help. Okay, so collective search help basically we can use to get the data from the multiple tables and display in a search for help. Okay, thank you.
If you like this video, then press the like button below. If you have any doubt, then write me in a comment section below. If you want to learn more about ABAP, then visit to my website www.learnsapapp.com. The link is also given in the description. and please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get notification about my next upcoming videos. Okay, so friends, bye, signing out.